It does feel like virtually every day there's some new situation arising out of the White House that the White House is trying to clean up and has to come back out and make new statements about, and new statements that often raise more questions.
Right, and it usually, by the way, a lot of the confusion flows from the top down.
Right.
I mean, this is a president who tweeted about, you know, Comey better hope that the conversations aren't taped. And this is a president who sat in the Oval Office with two Russians and apparently said some things, you know, he shouldn't have said. And this is why I talked to a couple of Republicans from the House today who were saying to me, this is why we're worried that our whole agenda is going to be derailed, because we're not trying to do tax reform, for example. And this is also why, Anderson, that you don't see a whole lot of Republican surrogates out there rushing to defend the president every time he does something like this, because they're not sure they should. And that's why you saw a Republican like McCain, who's been quite critical, saying, okay, I have to learn more about this, because they're getting hit by this every single day, and they don't know what to think from day to day.
And Kirsten, it's interesting, unlike the reaction on the day that Comey was fired, which they put out, you know, Kellyanne Conway, they put out everybody on different networks to just try to get their message out, and then it turned out what they were actually selling was not what the president himself decided to talk about the next day, which contradicted.
Yeah.
Tonight, they sent out McMaster in a very carefully worded statement that didn't really address the actual reporting,
right.
Same statement basically from Tillerson, and now they're saying, oh, we have no more statements tonight.
Yeah,
they're clearly, I mean, like in the bunker or somewhere.
Yeah, well, I also think it's interesting that you think of Dina Powell and H.R. McMaster, two pretty respected people who haven't really been tarnished yet in this administration, and they're sort of like the last people standing, and now they've been sent out and are probably going to be tarnished by what just went down tonight, which was very unorthodox in these sort of non-denial denials. And so, look, this all starts at the top with Donald Trump, and you can try different people giving different statements, but ultimately the problem is with him, and he creates this chaos and then sort of sends these people out to try to clean up these messes. But until he stops doing the things that are causing the messes, no communication strategy is going to solve the problem.
I mean, Matt, I guess the question is, at what point do Capitol Hill Republicans start to distance themselves from the president, or senators, or congressmen?
Yeah, look, I think Gloria made a very interesting point, which is that this is like almost a game theory. So if you're a Republican, if you're a conservative commentator or writer or whatever, a Republican politician, you're sort of balancing, like, is he Nixon? Is he McCarthy? Is he Reagan? Right? And there were conservatives like George Will who attacked. Now, Reagan didn't have until late in his administration the scandal part. But there were conservatives like George Will who attacked Reagan and ended up looking kind of silly and stupid because he became this iconic, you know, president and conservative figure. Is he Nixon? It's unclear. And so I think that you're having people hedge bets.
Right.
And I don't know when the tipping point's going to come, but at some point people will abandon him.
Well, Jeffrey Lord, I mean, if the president did what the Washington Post says he did, what the New York Times says he did, and basically which H.R. McMaster has not denied that he did, nor has Rex Tillerson. If the president did that, gave code word level classified information to the two Russians in the Oval Office, that then they could then go back and figure out the sources and methods and may put an ally's intelligence operatives in danger, or whomever it may be, and may affect intelligence sharing from our allies with the United States. Would you agree that that is bad?
Well, sure, if in fact that's exactly what he did. But Anderson, I think it will also open up, it will continue to open up the whole question of leaks and classified information. I mean, let's recall the irony here. This is a Washington Post story. And while I was waiting to go on, I noticed that in March of this year, Tom Hanks and Meryl Streep and some other Steven Spielberg announced they're making a movie of the Washington Post leak of the Pentagon Papers, which were entirely classified, and they're being celebrated for it. So I would just suggest that I think there's some confusion all over Washington.
Well, it seems like the most confusion that was coming out of the Oval Office, it doesn't seem like there's a lot of confusion coming out of the Washington Post, because the Washington Post actually has a really good track record, as does the New York Times, as does CNN, on their reporting on the Trump administration. And the stuff we've reported has all flushed out as true, and what they've come on TV to deny has turned out not to be true.
Anderson, let me just disagree with you. There were two stories from the Washington Post. One that the deputy attorney general had threatened to resign, which he personally denied to a Washington news channel. And secondly, that then Director Comey, had asked for more resources. And then the deputy director, the acting director, says to the U.S. Senate committee that that's not so, that he has no memory of that whatsoever. Those stories, right away, have a problem with them. So not everything that's written in the Washington Post is 100% accurate.
Well, Anderson?
Yes, go ahead, Gloria.
Look at this from the Russian point of view. So they've got chaos in the United States government, people arguing about whether they hacked the election or whether the transition team was in collusion with the Russians.
They've got their foreign minister and their ambassador in the friggin' Oval Office, meeting with the president and getting code word, according to reporting, code word level classified information directly from the president of the United States in the Oval Office.
Right,
you cannot make this up.
That's my next point. They walk into the Oval and they get all this information and they walk out and they go, wow, well, let's reverse engineer all this and we'll figure out who the source is, if they didn't already figure it out while they were sitting there. I mean, so they're sitting there and kind of laughing at all of this and saying, well, this was better than we thought when we hacked.
Thanks, everybody. Coming up.